Parks talks about how he got his first job as an artist.
I have been just always trying to learn how to draw and studying the way drawings were always related to an idea of some kind. And I was working at that time in the railroad car shops on a riveting gang, and I wanted to get away from that terribly hard work very much. And I got to looking at these joke magazines and decided that perhaps I could illustrate something that I could sell to a joke magazine. So I tried it, and I sold a little drawing. They didn't use the joke that went with the drawing, but they printed the drawing. In 1929, I think I sold the first drawing. In 1931, they offered me a job to go back there and work. 1942, set up a way of raising some chickens to make a living, and I was hoping that I could get on with comic books. Western Publishing came there and trying to find something that they could use in the way of a duck story or an adventure story using the Disney characters that would make a big full-size comic book, a long story. The animated Donald back in those days was a squatty guy. He seemed to have very rubbery legs, and I couldn't seem to get the kind of action I needed. I needed a Donald who could walk like a human. I found that I was very limited if I stayed with just the one Donald who was a squawky, fighty guy. I had to have a Donald who could do some thinking. 1948, when I was asked to do a Christmas story, so I invented a character named Scrooge, Uncle Scrooge. He's just Donald's rich uncle. He has money, and it's there for you to look at and see and just imagine how much that would weigh and how much pleasure it must give him to dive around in it. I think I created something that is a little bit of a something that most people would like to do. I never figured I'd ever have any more use for him than just that one story, but